everyone. I'm Ely Gaming here, and today we're playing Raid Shadow Legends, and we are joined by HellHades, finally. I'm so happy to have you on my channel, finally, HellHades. Thank you.
Not at all. I've actually, I know we've been like, talking about this for ages, so I'm really looking forward to this. We did.
Yeah, it was funny. I know you were open to collabing a while ago, and then life happened. You were buying a new house. Yeah. I was coming to Christmas in Romania, and then it was the holidays, so I was like, you know what, I'm just going to wait till I get settled and then revisit the idea that I had. I actually had this idea a long time ago.
Yeah, it's a cool one as well. I think it's a little bit novel and definitely something people wouldn't have seen before. So it should be good fun.
And of course, you guys know me. I'm a big supporter. HellHades is the reason I'm here. Literally, that's silly to say. It's dramatic. Not really. But I found Twitch because of you. I didn't even notice any of the other people, like all the people on YouTube, never really cared about Twitch. I was like, what's that? That sounds stupid. I don't want to watch people play games live. What?
Yeah. Like, I'm trying to think how long you've been watching for. You've been around for a while.
Before your face was on the screen, when you were doing your Clan Boss series.
Yeah, yeah. Back when I had no emotion with anything I said.
But we liked you anyway. Hey, what can I say?
Yeah, I got away with it.
That's what people want. They want personality. They want something. Someone that they vibe with. That they're like, I like this. I like their vibe. I'm gonna continue watching. And that's what brought me to Twitch. And then I luckily found all the other wonderful content creators in this community. And that's why I started streaming. Is because I love the community so much. I just thought it was such a great place, and I don't know, I think it's nice. Some games are toxic, but I feel like for the most part it's such a nice community.
Yeah, we're pretty lucky with that. I've played a lot of games where you would not want to be a content creator in those games, so yeah, we're pretty lucky with the raid community for sure.
So today my concept was, you know, I don't know if this is the same in every country, you could tell me, but in America we have a yearbook, like, kind of, I don't know, dedications, but they're like most likely to succeed, most likely to whatever, best hair, best whatever. Is that a thing? Do you know, is this something you're familiar with?
It's not really, like, so really, I think a lot of things from America are starting to come over to the UK. So things like, you know, the big prom and stuff like that. Yes. But we're nowhere near what the US do. So, and I think we will be. It kind of, you know, even things like Halloween. For us, Halloween you know what, we might make some cakes, but in the shape of fingers. Yeah, it was never like a big thing. Whereas every year that goes by, there's more and more people dressing up and it's becoming a bit more like Americanized. So we'll get there. We're just a bit slow.
So we're going to start off here with raids most likely to. We're going to be a little bit serious and a little bit fun. So I guess we can get into it. We'll start with the first one.
Yeah.
All right. Raid most likely to decrease your defense. I'll start with you, HellHades. What did you put for that one?
So I went with Ghostborn.
Oh.
Yeah. I thought I'd come at this from just because, like, he's the only champ that's got this decreased defense that can't be resisted. Yeah, Mr. Irresistible, that's it. So look, I mean, he could weak hit, you never know, but I thought he'd be a good shout. And he's also someone that people don't really give enough love to. I think Ghostborn's an awesome champ, and overlooked.
That's the little. Yeah. He's super important in my Fire Knight 25 team. He makes that happen. I couldn't imagine not having him. I use him highly now.
Yeah, he doesn't get the 3%, does he? He doesn't get that 3% chance to get resisted, which is when you're trying to get consistent teams, he's in the mix.
That's super funny. I think it's Dark Elves are the kings of decreased defense.
We've got two
that I couldn't decide between. We got a Lydia. We got a Madame Ceres. I think I actually have to go for my choice, Lydia, because she replaces everyone once you get her, as far as Doom Tower runs, dungeon runs, even arena. Like, she's just so good. And she's void, so you don't have to worry as much about those weak hits and negative affinity.
Yeah, I actually feel sorry for Draco since Lydia's come out, because Draco used to be your go-to, wasn't it? Draco was like, I really want to get
him. Don't need him anymore.
No, Lydia literally has just killed off Draco's. Yeah. Awesome champ. Well worth like the hassle, the grind to get from faction wars, I think.
I'll still say Madame Ceres, honorable mention. She does place decreased defense instead of hits. If you're doing something like Hydra Boss, you don't have to worry about poison clouds. So
she was actually who I thought about first. I was like, she's going to clean stuff off. She's going to lay it. But then it's like, no, let's go with Mr. Irresistible.
Actually, next one, most likely to decrease your attack. I'm going to go right back there. I'm going to go Madame Ceres.
That's who I picked. That was the same for me.
Because, again, the placing of it is one less thing you have to worry about.
I literally went with the same one. I was just thinking, you know, how many champs can clean everything off before they do it? And therefore, it's definitely done the land. Like, and again, Void Affinity, so good. Yeah, so good. I guess you could throw Plenty in there, but for me, she was the winner, outright winner. And she looks cool.
And she does look cool, you're right. All right, most likely to poison you. Who you got?
Yeah, so I've gone for the Doom Tower reward champion, Urost.
Oh, I love him.
So a little bit left field, I guess, but...
No, I like that.
You hit him. And he poisons you.
Yep.
So it's, I figured, true. Yeah, you know what? He's just going to stand there as a massive brick wall and still be like plying out those poisons. So, and I figured he deserves a mention somewhere. He's so good.
I literally just put my last YouTube video was Urost solo Scarab King because I wanted an up to date one out. Like, there's so many people that put us. We have all these solo build videos, but they're old. Like, I'm trying to, you know, keep some recent ones. And he's so perfect for the job. He replaced Virgus for me, for sure. And he's easy to build because you put no speed on him. You want him to actually be attacked more often. And so the runs at 100 are faster than the runs at the lower speeds, because at the lower levels, because he's getting attacked more often and placing more poisons.
Yeah, no, nice. I use him as well, actually. And okay. I had a free-to-play god, Eobard, who's in my streams. So he's got his own channel as well. And he managed to do a run, I think, where he only had one turn. So, you know, on Doom Tower, they have this kind of ranking system, like lowest turns is the best. And I'm pretty sure he only got hit, like, or he only actually hit one time with his Urost build, which is just insane. No, totally insane.
Oh, I know, because you could use, like, Avenging Gear to proc your counterattacks and stuff like that.
That's it.
Like Baron.
That's exactly it, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, Avenging Skullcrown, Avenging Barons. I know that was a big thing to get those cheater low turn off of the leaderboard.
Yeah, well, it's quite interesting. When you start talking to someone about how they're doing it, I mean, it's almost like playing a different game, but it's pretty cool.
Let's see.
So
here.
Who was yours?
I went with someone I don't have, but I would love to have. Cavillax.
Yeah,
I
Cavillax
wanted Cavillax
awesome.
To go with my Zavias. I have four Zavias. They're bored.
Yeah, I got Cavillax, and I mean, he's gone into a couple of my 25 teams, and he's so fun. He's such a fun champ. One of my favorites, actually.
Yeah, they did really good with this. Well, obviously, the person that designed that was obviously a graphic design person, or they were just already an artist to begin with. But this won that character design competition.
Yeah. No, it was awesome.
Super cool.
And I think the kit, although it's not like busted, but it's awesome.
Yeah.
It's really fun.
Hopefully I'll pull him one of these days. All right, let's see. Next up, most likely to make you burn. So I actually went with... Wait, I have to remember where he is. Because I always think he's in a different faction. For my choice here, I went Mordecai. Because, again, with the placing of HP burn, you don't have to worry about weak hits. So affinity doesn't matter. Hydro Boss, he's perfect against those annoying poison clouds. Just absolutely love him as an HP burn champion. And he's my Spider 25 team. HP
is he? Yeah.
As well.
He is good. He is really good, actually. Well, I kind of did the same. I went with the same idea of you get hit to burn. So I've gone with Drex. From the Bazaar. Just because I think, like, once you've got Drex, he changes Doom Tower for people. Like, he just makes Doom Tower so much more accessible. Basically, because he's got to sit and, like, stand there and take a hit. As soon as he takes a hit, he's got a good chance to throw a burn out there.
It's true.
So yeah, I think he actually ended up being a great reward for the Bazaar.
I agree. Actually, he was like my first or second champion I ever pulled. Legendary.
Oh, was he? Yeah.
Yeah, and I've used him for the beginning, so I always knew how valuable he was. And he was kind of underrated for a while until Doom Tower came out. Now you use him in almost every boss. He's so good.
Yeah, and he's good as a spider, like a normal spider tank as well. I think he's
That's
was always
true.
A bit
yes,
underrated,
definitely.
But now he's insane. He's so good.
All right, let's see. Most likely to block your buffs. What was your pick there?
Yeah, so I would go with... I think I'll go with Umbral. Umbral Bane. Enchantress.
That was my pick too, for sure.
Oh, was it? Yeah, just such a fun champ as well. Just, I think throwing out the block buffs was always good and it hits hard. But then a second follow-up skill is so nice as well. So
yeah,
I think a really fun champ actually.
Yeah, I like her because she books up to 100% chance to land, and it's for 3 turns. And then you add on like the masteries, it could be for 4 turns. Like that's a really long chance to place. So
and it's on a 3-turn cooldown, so it can just keep rotating around.
Yeah, exactly. 3-turn cooldown. She has the best cooldown for that as well. Like I like using Ugo, but she's just a little bit better. And plus, affinity wise, you don't have to again. Void always the better option if you can, especially in things like Hydra. I've started using her again.
Hydra big time,
I didn't use her much at all for a while, except for Faction Wars, but now she's getting a lot of use for me in Hydra.
Yeah, I mean, back in the day, I did an all-epics team for Arena, and Umbra was a big part of that, actually. She was... I tried pushing... I don't think you could do it nowadays. I like pushed into Plat, and it was a lot of fun. And Umbra was a big chunk of that team, using her block buffs and her provoke. But she's definitely coming back into the fray with Hydra, yeah, for sure.
Yeah. All right, most likely to remove your buffs. I actually went with the lovely, lovely Seer because Seer.
Yeah,
because so Seer. She's just, I mean, she's a support champion. Not really. She's a damage dealer, let's be honest.
Yeah.
That's just such a good utility to be able to remove buffs and turn that into damage at the same time, so... Use her everywhere. She's the Doom Tower Queen. She's the Speedrun Dungeon Queen. And even Hydra. She's super useful there as well.
Yeah. Yeah. I've actually got her on the free-to-play now.
Oh, that's crazy. I forgot.
Which is a huge... it's a huge pull on the free-to-play, yeah. But no, so I didn't go with her, although she's probably the best for it, actually. I went with Kaimar.
I wish I had a Kaimar.
And kind of does the same job in terms of... removes the buffs, but also creates some control as well. So, you know, cleans all the buffs off, sleeps them, and just gives your team time to do whatever they want to do. And he gets his A3 away as well and gives everyone a chance to do everything twice. I just feel like Kaimar's become like top draw legendary because of this ability, actually, that the A2 is actually what's made him
crazy.
Top for Arena.
He's my number one most wanted champion in the game still. I haven't...
Yeah, I bet.
Haven't pulled him. He's my... I know we have the same Void, Krisk, right?
Yes.
I haven't got a Krisk yet.
What's your view on this upcoming event? Are you going for it or not?
I'm going to try as much as I can based on my group, but if it's obvious that there's people that are going to outspend me, I'm just not going to bother. I don't have a ton of resources saved, so I could grind some, but there's no way I'm not going to spend hundreds of dollars just to get a Krisk. I'm just not going to do that. People are going to spend thousands, let's be honest.
Yeah, I'm basically in the same boat as that.
Okay.
I think I'll look to see what the group does
exactly
for a couple of days and then decide what I'm going to do. Yeah.
All right. So the next one is your other answer. Most likely to protect you from debuffs. That's your Siphi.
Well, see, I didn't go with that. So I've gone with something else.
Oh, okay.
I've gone for the new dwarf, Borogar.
Oh.
As a the legendary.
Oh, there he
is. The guy's got the golden head.
Yeah.
So because he can put increase resistance up,
I was figuring, I like that idea. That's a good way to look at it.
Yeah, I figured he's the only one out there at the minute who can, you know, effectively try and stop those debuffs landing on you.
I like that.
So yeah, and I think he looks kind of funky as well.
He does have a cool vibe for sure. He's almost got a Shadowkin meets. He's almost got an Asian vibe to his look.
Yeah, yeah.
I didn't even notice his... He got some book in the back. I don't know what's happening. They do such a good job, though. I love this game.
They do.
It's so fun.
It's so awesome, yeah. So what did you do? Which direction did you go
I went with Siphi. I went with block debuffs debuff.
Yeah.
Or block buffs, sorry. Block debuffs buff. That's a tongue twister. Yeah, I went with Siphi there just because she's so good to have, and especially in Arena, putting her against a Tormund, and she's she has a good base speed, so she's good to be the fastest champion to the rent. And then, I mean, her kit's just insane overall. So,
yeah, I mean, there's definitely a few that could come in and do the same job really well. Like her and Duchess seem to be the two that just kind of like stand out. But yeah, awesome champ, Siphi, even with a slight nerf. She's still one of the best. Yeah,
I love how she got nerfed, but it doesn't... Oh, all they did was nerf her for Clan Boss. That was terrible.
Yeah,
that's
did
all
they
really
did.
They
reduce, I know they reduced her speed
reduced
a little bit,
the
didn't they?
Cooldown on something. Oh, is that too? Yeah. Oh, yeah, you're right. The turn meter a little bit, but overall, it didn't affect how she plays in Arena
still
at all.
Still crazy.
What's next? All right, most likely to protect all allies. Who'd you put?
Yeah, so I've gone for the big lizard, Krisk.
Same.
Did you? Yeah. So just like start of the round, massive shield, big provokes. So I just feel like ally protection is so, everything about his kit is so bonkers.
He literally protects in every way possible.
Yeah.
Protect the literal buff, which I was referring to. And then he heals everyone. He provokes so they don't get hit in the first place. And of course, the shields from the beginning. He's kind of. That's why we all want him.
He's so good.
He's so good.
Oh, dear.
I actually think I want him most for Hydra because that's where the people are really able to pump out the serious teams that are more successful and not make you be as frustrated and want to punch things and waste hours of your day.
I do want to have a pop at, though. I want to have a pop at the world record. I don't think I'll get the world record, but the world record clan boss team. I want to build that myself and have a go with my deer. I think that'd be a load of fun.
That's fair. Yeah. He's a part of all of those crazy comps, isn't he?
Yeah. And that's a shame, isn't it? When Hydra came out, you're hoping that you'd need to use different champs, but it does feel like the best champions for other stuff are still the best champions there, which is a bit of a shame.
All right, let's see. Next, we have most likely to shield your team.
Shield your team. So you go first this one.
I had a... Krisk was a debate, because that is literally, that's what he does the second he opens.
Yeah.
But I will probably go with Brogni, just because his shield is special. It's different. We don't have any other in the game that allows you to like not have it removed. So, at least, is he the only shield that can't be removed, I think, right?
Yeah, I think so. I picked him as well. But also, he's the only guy that can buff a shield. He's the only guy that can keep it like pumping up, which is like an awesome ability. It's so good for
super
the game.
Cool.
Yeah,
I missed the fusion because I forgot to finish Ice Golem tournament because I was distracted by CVC. So I missed getting one set of fragments for Fenchie or whoever it was.
Yeah, and that was it.
Luckily,
you couldn't regain it.
That was it. They didn't. That was like the hardest fusion. There was like no chance to kind of go in. Like I was asking, like, can you please put out a pack? I'll buy it. And they had no packs until after the fusion was over. That was when we're like, guys, what are you doing?
Oh yeah.
Remember that? They put out like a Mordecai pack after the fusion was over. And I'm like, wait, what? This doesn't make sense. People would have probably spent because if they missed it like I did, it was a bummer. But I pulled
him
eventually.
I take it you've got him since. Yeah, I can see you've got him. Yeah. I think Ash did the same actually. Oh, Ash just skipped it completely and eventually got him again. Yeah.
Best fusion ever so far, maybe? Yeah.
I think so. Most like accessible champion to just go anywhere and be like nuts. So yeah. Yeah, I think so.
It's time to get silly now. Ready to get silly. All right. Most likely to beat you in an arm wrestling competition.
Yeah. So I've gone with a little bit left field on this one. I've gone with the orc. I've gone with Nodgar. Because I feel like, you know, when you get one of those kind of smaller dudes, but he's properly pumped. And I'm thinking that people would underestimate this guy. And you never know. Like sometimes the smaller dudes are pretty strong and scrappy. So yeah, Nodgar for me is coming in as a scrappy dude that's going to take down some of the giants.
I like that. And to be fair, let's be honest, all of these characters could beat me in an arm wrestling competition, to be fair. But we'll just say, who would we want to pin up as our champion to fight for us? There we go. Mm. I went with the big old Turvold. I couldn't
remember. Like,
he's just such a beast. I don't have one on my account yet. I've never been able to play around with him. He's got I don't even know. Is this a tattoo? What's even happening here? I don't know. But
yeah, I mean, honestly, I wouldn't want to face him.
No.
I wouldn't want to face him in an arm wrestling competition at all.
He's got the big sword like Jotun. He's just kind of...
But he can actually hit with it.
All right, let's see. Most likely to chop off your head in one fell swoop. I went with Genbo. Because he's fast. He's got the double crazy swords. Look at those.
Oh, yeah.
I'd be scared of that. You think some crazy anime... Like he's
quick as well, isn't he? Actually, yeah, you wouldn't see it coming.
His animations are really fast, so you wouldn't even have a chance.
Well, I've gone with very different. So again, I've gone in orcs actually.
Okay.
this guy's just going to hack at you. I've gone with King Garog.
Ah.
With his massive kind of double.
God. Oh my God. Yeah.
Serrated, whatever they are. I don't know what they're called. But yeah, I just figured this guy.
That's scary.
Yeah. I think it's at least a one shot anyway on the head.
That's a really good call. And it's like a slice too.
Yeah. 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 I wouldn't want to see those coming at me.
See, we got to do some things that are just a nod to the amazing graphics and the fun aspects of this game besides good. All the serious stuff. And it's so good. It's so crazy.
I feel like this guy deserves to be the hardest hitting champion in the game. Like,
he looks so awesome.
Badass, doesn't he? Yeah.
He does. It's like, who is it? Jotun has a giant sword too, but he's like, meh.
Yeah. We got the plastic version.
Yup. All right. Most likely to beat you in a foot race. Speedy.
Oh, yeah. Okay. I went with Panthera from the Skinwalkers.
Yeah. That's fair. It's a dang panther.
Yeah. I was looking through the Skinwalkers. I was like, one of these has got to be quick. And I was like, oh, yeah, here we go. This is the one.
That's fair.
To be fair, most of these could probably beat me in a foot race, but
same. I'm super out of shape. I danced at a party and then I couldn't walk for 3 days.
Really?
Like I was like walking all bow-legged down the stairs.
Yeah, I still play football, like Sunday league football, and I take at least 3 days recovery nowadays. Like, my back goes, the legs are gone. It's not good. Who did you go with?
I actually went with Lady Kimmy. She is so quick. Her animations are insane.
She is quick.
It's actually super funny. I love when I'm using like unlimited frame rate and on 2x speed. It looks like you're using like the cheat engine, and we're not. But it looks like it. You're like, wait, how are like the shadow can move so fast when it's at 2x speed? It feels like you're cheating. You're like, is it glitching? What's happening?
Yeah, good shout. Good shout.
She's super fast. And then, I actually remember when they had the dragon. Was it dragon with the Shadowkin and dwarves like that? I think it was. Yeah. So the dwarves were like the slowest moving faction, and then the Shadowkin were the fastest. So it was really funny watching them play together. That was just hilarious watching it the runs. I actually had quite a laugh with that. All right, let's see. Next one I have most likely to give you nightmares.
Yeah. So I've gone with the new. Champion Mithrala.
Oh,
is she Dark Elf?
No, wait, why do I think she's Demon Spawn? She should be Dark
Elf.
Yeah,
Dark Elf. Yeah.
Oh, yeah, right. She's not a
so kind of Medusa look. Imagine waking up and looking around and seeing that. It would be
the snakes, and most people hate snakes, so that's fair.
Yeah.
Yeah, she actually reminds me of someone I used to always have weird nightmares about. From like, there was like some Star Trek character when I was a kid that I saw that I always haunt. For some reason, it always stuck in my brain, and I always be scared. And I would come out of my room, and I thought she was like crawling around the corner of the hallway. Kind of reminds me of her. I don't know. Little kid things that stay in your head forever.
Yeah. Who was yours?
I went with someone that's just gross because I went with a drowned bloat wraith. He's just nasty.
Yeah. Actually, now you show me this one, I'm thinking of as well that there's that Shadowkin who's like carrying around at the top of heads a vagabond.
Layla feeds him every. Layla feeds her every time she gets him. She just sacrifices her immediately. I think she's still doing that anyway.
Yeah.
She's so
That's not
greedy.
Someone you'd want to meet. That's not someone you want to meet at the market,
look at
is
that
it?
Face. No, thank you. All right, we got one more fun one. So, most likely to be in a boy band.
Yeah.
Who'd you go with?
So, I've gone with Scrapper.
Oh, hilarious.
I feel like he's the rare, isn't he? I feel like you could just see him, you know, giving it his all. Probably in the same outfit.
He's like got this clean cut haircut, but he's a barbarian. Like, that doesn't make sense. I think they put them in the wrong faction because this is not a barbarian. Where is the scruffly beard and mustache? Like, how would he do this? Look at this fade. You don't do that if you're a
No, he's out of his, he's out of place for sure.
So that's a good call. He'd be
more in place with a boy band. Yeah,
I actually went with Inquisitor Chamel. He reminds me of Marcel from Blazing Squad. That's a UK reference there.
Yeah.
I only know that because of watching Love Island. Don't judge me. There was the guy who was in that was on Love Island. and he just kind of looks like him. He's like a little bit too clean cut too. He feels out of place along with this like Harrier.
Like Harrier, I thought he was going to pick Harrier, yeah.
Yeah, him and Harrier are kind of
Harrier looks like Harry Styles, doesn't he? It looks like Harry Styles.
That's true, actually. That's true. I just went with Inquisitor Chamel because they have, like, the same kind of skin with the same, like, weapon and same, like, outfit vibe. But he actually kind of looks like the guy.
For sure.
Oh, that's funny.
Nice.
Alrighty. Well... this is actually a two-part thing, guys. So we're going to have some more fun and some more laughs. We're going to be serious and we're going to be not so serious again. Over on HellHades channel, we're going to do Raid's Best. Again, the yearbook dedication type thingy. Raid's, like, best hair, best whatever, best funny stuff. We're going to go Raid Shadow Legend style and we're going to continue this conversation. So make sure you head on there after. I'll make sure I have links in the description. Of course, I'll have links to his website as well. An amazing tool. Obsessed. Everyone loves the optimizer. I can't imagine life without like RSL Helper and the Optimizer these days.
Oh, I know.
You know?
I know. It's such like both of them are amazing tools. They're so good. Yeah, so good.
But thank you again for joining me on the channel. It's been a long time coming and I really appreciate all the support you've shown me as a newbie content creator as I started. So thank you.
Oh, well, thanks for having me on. And look forward to carrying on my channel. Be good.
All right. Thank you guys for watching and I'll see you in the next video.